The story of the Omega Rangers is a bit complex, and I recommend that, to better understand this story, you should watch the story of Lord Draken in this channel after this video. I also recommend watching the story of the Morphin Masters, which is also in this channel as everything is connected. You can watch these videos after watching this story just to better understand everything. In the events of Mighty Morphin Power Rangers, when Tommy appears after losing his powers as the Green Ranger, Zordon gives him the powers of the White Ranger, and for some strange reason Zordon makes him the leader of the team without having so much time on the team. This is something quite unusual since the leader had always been Jason and the second in command had been Zack, and they had been Rangers for a long time. The weirdest thing about this is that Jason never said anything about Tommy now being the leader and him becoming second in command. For years none of us fans understood this logic, as it took us all by surprise, and even though Tommy has proven to be a good leader, it was still a strange decision. After many years, it was explained that the Blue Emissary, who was the representative of the Morph Masters, had appeared before Jason to give him the task of forming a new team of Rangers to help in the approaching battle. Earlier, Zordon had spoken to the three emissaries and told them that Lord Draken was very powerful and dangerous to the entire universe. This would become a great threat to everyone, but at the time the three emissaries thought Zordon was exaggerating and took it in stride, only to later realize they were wrong and saw how dangerous Lord Draken was. When the Blue Emissary appeared to Jason, he told him about the mission and brought back memories of the battle against Lord Draken. He also told him that he had to create a new team of Rangers in order to fight in the coming war. Jason replied that somehow, he had to get Tommy back since he didn't want to involve his team in this, and that's why the power of the White Ranger suddenly appears. Jason goes to the command center along with the Blue Emissary, and although he tries not to be seen by anyone, Trini and Zack appear and are surprised by the presence of the Blue Emissary. At that moment, Jason and the Blue Emissary say nothing to them, but later Zack and Trini have a conversation about whether they are going to tell the others about this emissary. At that moment, the Blue Emissary appears to them, and despite everything he tells them about the plan he had with Jason. Later, Zack and Trini meet Jason and tell him that they already know about the plan and that they are not going to leave him alone in this mission. Quickly the three begin to do missions for the Blue Emissary, and in the midst of it all they begin to think who can replace them as Rangers, since they know they cannot leave the other Rangers alone. They descend on a planet where they meet Kia, who, after showing her power, the villagers of her planet attack her and the Rangers go to help her. The Rangers continue to run missions in search of beings that were hit by the events of the Shattered Network, and during all of that they realize the great power of Kia and decide to join the team. Now they must find a good excuse to get out of the Mighty Morphin team in order to start their new team. This is the part that many of us already saw when Jason, Zack and Trini tell Zordon that they have to go to Switzerland for a peace conference, which I think is a lousy excuse, since if you go to a conference, you can get back pretty quickly, and you don't need to be replaced as a Ranger. Still, Zordon asks them to find his replacement, to which Jason looks for Rocky, Trini for Aisha, and Zack for Adam. After this, The Blue Emissary takes the Rangers along with Kia to a safe place at the Point of Eternity and tells them about who the Omega Rangers were at the beginning of it all. He tells them that the time has come to complete the circle of the Morphin Grid, and he is going to show them the Alpha and the Omega. The Blue Emissary tells him,
"A millennium ago, the first Rangers patrolled the edge of dark space facing enemies and protecting the innocent. The connection to the Morphin Grid was ancient and primitive, but the Rangers told stories of its power. Swift as the torrential winds and sturdy as the earth beneath our feet. They fought as if fire tucked the creatures and streams of water drowned all opponents who faced them. The only explanation for the powers contained in these gauntlets was magic interpreted as a form of alchemy. But you know the truth. The ranks of these rangers have lain dormant for far too long, used only when needed in times of great danger. As it is now."
At that moment the emissary gives him the gauntlets which were the morphers used by the first rangers and which possessed the power of wind, water, earth and fire. The power of the wind would be for the yellow ranger which is Trini, then gives the power of the earth which is the black ranger which is Zack, then gives the power of fire to the Red Ranger which is Jason and ends delivering the power of water to the new Blue Ranger which would be Kia. With all these powers together the new Omega Rangers of this era are formed, and which will have an important history in the franchise. Also, the Blue Emissary introduces them to their new Zords which were the first machines built for the Rangers and had an alien appearance. The mission of the Omega Rangers is to search for all those beings throughout space affected by the network and who now have powers, but are confused and do not know what is happening to them. Some of these beings will become allies, but others will use their new powers for evil and will have to fight them. If you like the Omega Rangers, like this video, and subscribe to this channel to be an Omega Power Ranger.